What's up, guys? How are you doing? And happy new year. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Cess Paulo, and if this is your first time here, don't forget to subscribe and also turn on the notification bell so that you get notified every time I upload a new video. So for this new year, I want to declutter before date 10. I want to declutter and reorganize my house because I need to get more organized. Like you see this shoe rack, it has so many shoes that I do not use. So I put my brain to a lot of stress when I'm trying to choose shoes, and I'm like, I have about maybe 20 or 30 pairs of shoes and I only wear like 3 pairs. So you can imagine putting your mind through that, going to choose among 20 shoes when you know you only wear 3. So it's going to be easier for me and also for you. If you have clutter, just get rid of the things you don't use anymore because they just make your life chaotic, and I don't want chaos in my life. I just want an easy life where I see this, I pick it and I wear it. So today we are going to be decluttering my shoe rack, as you can see it here. This shoe rack is actually like the second shoe rack I bought since I was born. The other one was not even a shoe rack. It was a stand for clothes, and then it had like a place down there for shoes. But now this is my first ever real shoe rack, and I don't think I'm getting rid of it soon. So I'm going to declutter it, organize it, and then I'm going to transform it in the future. But today's video is all about decluttering your shoe rack. So let's go ahead and begin this video. And by the way, this shoe rack also acts as my bag holder, as you've seen at the top there. So first of all, we're going to remove these shoes, get rid of these heels. I used to love them. They used to mean so much to me, but it's time for them to go because they bring back bad memories. Yeah, so off they go. These ones I don't even wear. I just kept them because I didn't want my shoe rack to be empty. I did a DIY on that a very long time ago. And then we have this other pair. I love it so much. It's not destroyed, but I lost one shoe. Like, I used to love this shoe so much. I've only worn it like 3 times, but one pair fell down when I hanged it on the balcony and I have never found it. So time for it to go. And then we have these other pairs. Now the flat shoes, okay, they're still good, but I feel they don't look good anymore. And I'm like, if I want new shoes, I have to show God I don't have shoes. Right now, God looks at my shoe rack and he sees it's full. So why, if he gives me new shoes, where am I going to put them? So I just decided any shoe that does not suit me anymore, it has to go because it's a new year, a new me. Yes, so these flats too are also in good condition, but the sole is getting off and also it's kind of too tight, like it's getting too tight for me. So I don't want to ruin my feet anymore. By the way, if you have shoes that are ruining your feet, no matter how beautiful they are, no shoe is worth your toes. That I can promise you. Like, I've messed up my feet using tight shoes, and I can tell you the struggle to correct them is not easy. So if you have shoes that are not good for your feet, if they are zinakufinya toes or the back parts, just let go of them. You'd rather wear slippers that are not going to ruin your feet. Believe me, you, the most utter, don't even care about old shoes, but if a shoe is not fitting your feet, just get rid of it. So now we're going to get rid of these boots. I used to love them so much, but they've faded. Like, the purple is faded. Like, if you wear it, and I don't want to apply suede cleaner on them, so let them just bye-bye. So as you can see, clearly I have gotten rid of almost all my shoes. As you can see here, I'm left with these 3 boots, and I think I should also get rid of them because I really don't wear them, but I feel I've not worn them enough to get rid of them. But well, I'm still bargaining in my mind if to get rid of them, especially the Timberlands, because they also bring bad memories back. I think they just have to go, but let's see. So for the heels, as you can see, I've only been left with one pair of heels that I can actually wear, and that is stressing me out. Like, how the fuck am I supposed to, oh my god, sorry, how the f am I supposed to use one pair of heel? Also for my handbags, I've realized I also have handbags that I don't use that I would never wear outside the house. So why have them? Like, I don't plan on wearing bags inside the house. So if I can't live with them, they have to go. And so for the shoes, you can either decide to take them to charity, but don't take shoes that are going to ruin people's feet to charity. Because if you take them, they're needy and they're going to wear shoes that are going to mess them up. So only take to charity shoes that are good, that they're suitable for humans to wear. Don't take to them shoes that are bad. So here I'm going to sort out the good ones, and then you can take them to charity. The bad ones, you just take them to the dustbin. And so you can see I have two bags here. Those ones were for this shoe rack, and so finally they are gone. How often do you guys declutter and reorganize your place? Because it's very recommendable. If you find like your life is becoming chaotic, you're not able to choose between your clothes, you always have so many clothes and shoes on your bed, when you're deciding to choose, maybe it's time for you to declutter and only remain with the things you're sure you're going to wear. Don't say, I will wear this one for, I don't know, for 1 year you've been saying you're going to wear something and you've never worn it. Why do you still have it? If you have not worn something for 6 months to 1 year, unless it's those clothes for cold seasons, just get rid of them. Because I have so many things I kept on saying I'll wear it one day, and trust me, I never wore them. So just declutter your life, get rid of shoes you don't use anymore, bags you don't use anymore, people who are not serving your purpose, who are not there, they're not on your team. Get rid of those things, those people, and you will thank me later. So as you can see, for this shoe rack, there's that part, you see the brown there, it's because I had to lift this shelf. So the upper shelf, it was big but not big enough for a 5-inch heel, and I want to buy a 5-inch heel. So I went ahead and adjusted the shelf so that it can fit the higher heels. And yes, I think I have now two sections that can fit really high heels, which I didn't have before. Before I even had to bend my shoes to put them in the shoe rack, but not anymore. But anyway, that is how my shoe rack currently looks, empty. And I think that actually only two pairs are going to come back. Two of the old pairs of shoes are going to come back. So my shoe rack will literally have two pairs until it's full. And I'm okay with that, because now God can see my shoe rack is empty and I need shoes. He can see how much in need I am. And as you can see, that's what I meant when I said like shoes couldn't fit, but now they can fit. Yes, so time now to wash my shoes. Transform my shoe rack. I'm going to transform it a little bit, not much. I'm not going to do much on it, maybe just repaint it and see any DIY I can do on them. But meanwhile, that is how it looks. And I think I made a very good choice when I bought this shoe rack, because I bought a shoe rack with how many, 1, 2, 3, 4, I can't count, that's like seven shelves. So that's very good. And I also have this part of the shoe rack, like it's below where I put my makeup, and I have these pairs of shoes that have also been here for the longest time. And guys, I don't even wear these shoes. I used to do them when I was going to the field, but I'm not going to the field anymore, so they have to go too. So off with the old and in with the new that we are praying for. So now that we are done with decluttering our shoes, don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, like, share, comment, share it with your friends, tell them about decluttering, also read about decluttering. And you can also watch motivational videos for decluttering. If you don't feel like you're not motivated, you don't have the zeal to do it, just go and watch some inspiration like this. And I'll see you in the next video. I love you all.